Happy holidays, Kryptonians. Merry Christmas to each and every one of you out there that celebrate Christmas and are spending the day with your families. I hope you all have a great time. Normally, I wouldn't be working on Christmas. I'd be kicking my feet up, opening presents, watching some basketball. I still plan on doing some of that, but I also wanted to bring you guys some review. Unfortunately, with the way my schedule breaks out, I wasn't able to get to all the films that I'm going to be talking about in this video. I figured since the year is coming up, it's like, holy shit, next week is January. I figured why not tie all the reviews together in one video, kind of like a bundle, and just give the reviews here to you, like really short reviews that condense my thoughts on what each of these films were. Keep in mind, the six films that I'm going to talk about in this video, I'm not going to have the attention to detail on these movies that I normally would if I were making a singular individual video about each individual movie. These are not going to be in-depth, these are not going to be fleshed out, these are just my general thoughts on these movies and whether or not I would recommend that you go out and see them, or if they're on Netflix, whether you click in and see it. Alright, let's get this show on the road. First up, let's talk about some Netflix movies. The first one I'm going to talk about is a movie called Mowgli. Mowgli is a Netflix movie that was directed by Andy Serkis. Originally, it was meant to come out in theaters like back in October or whatever, but they delayed it. They pushed it to December, and then Netflix acquired the distribution rights and decided to, you know, release it on Netflix. The voice talent for this movie is crazy. You've got Andy Serkis also doing the voice talent of Baloo, I believe, in this movie. You've also got Christian Bale, Kate Blanchett, Benedict Cumberbatch. Essentially, this movie is just a darker version of the Jungle Book movie that you saw back in 2016. Apparently, it follows more the spirit and tone of the books. If you haven't read the Jungle Book books, don't feel bad. I haven't read them either. But apparently, if that was their goal, to make it a darker and more mature story, then mission accomplished, because this movie is definitely not a movie that I would probably recommend to the kids. The voice talent in this movie is really insanely good. It elevates all of the characters that I have grown up watching in other mediums. Visually speaking, I would probably say it's definitely up there. It ranks right there with 2016's version of the Jungle Book. That was a Disney film. This film is pretty much walking green screen every single scene, but it looks really beautiful. Story-wise, though, I would say that this movie is a little bit of a mess. There are some pacing issues. There are some things that happen in the story that I feel like could have been fleshed out more and as a result could have had more impact. The story feels like it's meandering and it doesn't have a clear focus, and there are some times where the movie just struggled to hold my interest, honestly. Having said that, I think it's a solid movie. I'd probably recommend it, but like on the low end of Man of Steel, probably Man of Steel Golden Age. I mean, you could check it out, but you know, check it out when you're bored or something. Next up on the list, we have another Netflix movie that's called Bird Box. Bird Box, I think, was directed by somebody named Suzanne Beer, and it is a post-apocalyptic movie. Just like Mowgli, it had a limited theater release, and then it got a release on Netflix, and so it's actually a pretty damn good movie, and I'm glad that I got a chance to see it before the year was over. The movie is instantly going to be compared to a movie like A Quiet Place, which came out earlier this year. That movie was also post-apocalyptic, and it focused on monsters. This one is the same thing, although in that one, you at least get to see them, and here you don't. It features a handicap for the main characters. In that movie, it was the whole, you can't make any noise. If you make a noise, if you make any sound, you end up dead. This movie operates more off of your sense of eyesight. Like, you can't look at the things that are in this movie, because if you look at them, they're gonna make you kill yourself. So I like post-apocalyptic movies that have that vibe where they challenge the characters to survive in different ways. I mean, we take our eyes for granted. Imagine being chased by something, terrorized by something that you couldn't look at. Something is attacking you and trying to kill you, or at least force you to kill yourself, but you don't know where it is and you can't look at it. So you have to go around in the movie with blindfolds. Definitely the movie could have answered a few more of my questions that I had related to these supernatural things, and then there are some story decisions where I'm like, I don't know if that really made the most sense. And the pacing was a little bit off in the first half of the movie because they cut between these two different storylines, and one of them was less interesting than the other, and then the other one was less interesting than the other, and it just kind of kept switching up. I'd probably recommend this one highly, though. I'd probably put it in the Silver Age for Man of Steel. It's a damn good movie. You should definitely check it out on Netflix when you get a chance. Next up on the list is a movie called Green Book. Green Book stars Mahershala Ali and Viggo Mortensen, aka Aragorn, son of Arathorn, heir to the throne. Okay, you know what? I probably shouldn't put Lord of the Rings shit in this video. Sorry, people, I call him Aragorn out of habit. He'll always be Aragorn to me. So anytime I see Viggo in a movie, I'm kind of like, what the hell is Aragorn doing in this movie about these two friends befriending each other on this southern trip? That's apparently what the movie is. The movie is about these two friends who become friends while one of them has to drive the other one around. Mahershala Ali plays a talented musician who has to go around performing, and Viggo Mortensen is his driver, and they develop a friendship and a bond. A really nice friendship and bond, too. I mean, honestly, the entire movie is resting on the chemistry between these two actors, and they really kill it. They crush it. Beyond that, I think the movie has really good music. It has really good cinematography. It's got a really good message about overcoming your differences and overcoming the hatred that you see in the world. Definitely highly recommend this one too. I wouldn't give it my highest rating, but I would probably put it in the Silver Age for Man of Steel, just like Bird Box. Robin Hood is just, it was just so generic and so forgettable that I didn't even want to review this movie when it came out, but the end of the year is here and I just like, ah, screw it. Let me add another one to my belt. Taron Egerton, I usually like him as an actor. I feel like he was miscast as Robin. In fact, fact, I feel like a lot of the actors in this movie were miscast, including Jamie Foxx. Definitely respect the fact that they tried to do something a little different with the Robin lore, I guess, but nothing ever comes together the way that I think they wanted it to come together in this movie. At times, the acting is bad. At times, it's overly cheesy. At times, the dialogue is painful to sit through. The action sequences aren't even really all that good. In the end, I'm left with a movie that definitely could have been a lot worse, but definitely should have been a lot better, and I'm forced to sit here in 2018 and go, can we retire Robin Hood as a thing? Can we, like, stop trying to make this a thing? Because it's clear at this point, it's just not a thing. Overall, this movie was kind of forgettable and bad. I'd probably say it's a guilty pleasure movie. Put it in Smallville, call it a day. Then you have a movie like The Nutcracker in the Four Realms, which, oh my god, this movie, why? I found myself thinking that throughout the entire runtime of this generic Chronicles of Narnia ripoff. Why? Just why? Why did we need this? Why did this happen? Why? Just why? The only good thing I could say about the movie is that the main actress, I forget the young girl's name, she was actually pretty good in the movie. She's the one watchable element. I feel like in this movie, the execution was definitely off. A lot of forgettable, bland characters. Some of the special effects didn't even really look all that convincing. Keira Knightley is a complete cartoon in this movie, and not a cartoon in the fun way. A cartoon in the really painful way. Overall, The Nutcracker in the Four Realms, it's just, why? You're like, you don't even really need to see it. I don't know if that many people did see it. I'd probably put it in the Kryptonite section of my show, where it's a bad movie. It's not completely god-awful, but it's just bad. It's just like, why? The final movie on this list is a movie that came out a long, long, long time ago, like earlier in the year, months and months and months ago. I didn't see it when it came out at that time, and then I finally got a chance to see it recently when it was on digital or whatever, and that is The Strangers Pray at Night, which I regret my decision. This movie was complete shit. I mean, there's just so much to hate about this movie. Literally, it's just an hour and 20 minutes of really dumb decisions. I suppose I could say that it's actually an hour and 20 minutes of really shitty screenwriting, but sure, let's just go with the bad decisions thing. The characters are so dumb and so unlikable. There's no way you're rooting for any of them. They're just generic killers who like killing, and then for some reason, they tried to make this movie an 80s throwback by playing 80s music anytime the killers were about to kill somebody or something. It's not even a decision that the movie made. Like, one of the killers decided to actually turn the music on before he killed somebody for really no reason at all. You can make a movie feel like a throwback 80s nostalgia type of movie without throwing that type of shit in my face all the time. Come on, man. In the end, this movie has really shitty characters, shitty decisions, shitty writing. It was a movie that was an hour and 20 minutes long and somehow felt even longer than that. The movie was absolute garbage. I feel justified in saying that it probably would get my worst rating on this show, Quest for Peace, because it's just a dumpster fire, man. It's just shit. There's just nothing I can really recommend about this movie. Alright guys, those are my thoughts on the movies that I have seen and the movies that I didn't get a chance to review, and now I get a chance to review them in this video. Like and subscribe to the Superfan Show, and if you like what you see, tell me how you feel, and stay tuned to hear more from the Man of Steel. Merry Christmas!